Joining us now, our next guest will lend us his vantage point and experience for an outside looking in perspective, not really outside, but mix of outside and inside. He was finance secretary from 2005 and 2010 under then President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Margarito Teves joins us live. Secretary, thank you so much and welcome to Market Edge.
Good morning. Thank you for your invitation.
Thank you for taking time to join us in studio. I'm going to go straight ahead, sir. What do you think is the biggest hit and the biggest miss of President Marcos in his first year?
Yes, okay. I think the biggest hit was the condonation of the payment of interest and loans of the agrarian reform beneficiaries.
Mm. Very recent.
Yes, this would allow this group to have access to the financial institutions, which will then allow them to buy the necessary materials for their farms, increasing their productivity and income.
Okay. You know?
And then, of course, the ratification of the Philippines entering into the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, mm-hmm. which would allow the entry of our goods to a large market, the biggest market in the world, and at the same time allow our agricultural crops to be protected for quite some time, which was the fear of our farmers. No? Mm-hmm. And then the passage of the implementing rules and regulations on the Public Service Act, mm-hmm. no? Which most investors normally would wait. So there's clarity that both the spirit and the substance of the law are actually reflected. Mm-hmm. No? Mm-hmm. Then the issuance also of the implementing rules on the Energy Act, mm-hmm. which allows foreign investors to invest up to 100% equity mm-hmm. in renewable energy. Mm-hmm. So those are the big hits of the president and his administration.
And the big misses?
Well, I think that while inflation has been going down, I think there's still need to ensure that this can be sustained, especially on the supply side of the inflation mm-hmm. problem. The supply side would be actually the production of agricultural produce, alternative sources of energy, transport, and so on. I think the latest figure indicated that the inflation rate is about 6.1% now, from a high of over 8%. That's okay. Fine, but I hope we can go back to somewhere between 4 to 5%.
Okay. No,
and then
this is headline inflation, sir.
For what?
For headline inflation.
For headline inflation.
All right.
No, and then we'd like to also give more flexibility to the labor market by allowing the training of workers, those who would be working apprentice, for example, from a period of 6 months to 2 years, to allow for, more knowledge and skilling, upskilling and reskilling. And they would be actually more in demand if they're able to train a little bit more than the usual 6 month period.
So meaning, sir, it will have to take 2 years before they become regular employees?
Something like that. The details, I think we can go into it, but right now it's only for 6 months.
Yes.
So there's reluctance on the part of many employers to get them.
No. Employers are saying it's hard to hire, but it's much harder to fire.
Yes.
That's right. Okay. Any other misses, sir?
I think, it's already passed. It's come into law. I was hoping, like Stevie and others, that there was more time to discuss some of the elements of the Maharlika investment fund. But as I mentioned, it's already passed into law. Let's try to help the administration.
How can it work, sir? How can it be more acceptable?
First, for the next 6 months, I think they're starting now, get to see whether we can really attract fund managers, maybe close to the younger version of a Warren Buffett. Whether locally and even internationally, mm-hmm. because somebody like him could attract already mm-hmm. or could catch the attention of potential
investors. Does that guy exist, sir?
Sorry?
Does that person exist?
I don't know if they're available, but it could be a combination of that team, no? mm-hmm. both local and international.
Okay.
And of course, the composition of the board. Mm-hmm. There are two regular directors and three independent directors. Mm-hmm. Hopefully, these are people who have the qualities of, again, a Warren Buffet or close to him, mm-hmm. Integrity, energy, yeah. and competence. No?
All right.
And they need to gel together. And they need to work on the projects that can match with the available seed capital mm. of $125 billion. You know?
Secretary, I'm very curious because you mentioned agriculture earlier, that you hope to see more productivity. Do you think that the president holding the agricultural post, which is no small post, do you think that's a wise move, or is he biting off more than he can chew?
Yeah, my preference would have been really, by now he should have appointed a permanent secretary, no, of agriculture, but that is his decision, no. That is so. What can we do? Well, one he has to find a time to really look for somebody who can help him monitor the projects that will, as I mentioned, improve the supply side, mm-hmm. Production, productivity, and also the supply chain. Mimi, what is the supply chain? It's really from the production all the way to the market, transport, warehouses. You know, if we have this in place with the help of the private sector, this will help reduce the influence of profiteers and smugglers and so on, because logistics alone, for example, account for about anywhere between 20% to 40% of the total cost. Mm. So that's why most farmers have preferred to sell their produce at the farm level. And then, of course, the consumers suffer in the process because of inadequate logistics, transport, and warehousing, etc. By the time the goods are in the market, the prices are really very high. Yeah. You know? Mm.
Mr. Secretary, speaking of farmers, Land Bank of the Philippines and Development Bank of the Philippines, the merger. You headed Land Bank, right? at one point, for many years, you headed Land Bank of the Philippines. And now, there's a big push to merge the two with Land Bank as a surviving entity. It would create the biggest bank in the Philippines, bigger than BDO. Do you agree that the merger should happen? And is Land Bank able to do and fulfill its mandate?
Yeah. Okay, I'll be biased, maybe.
Okay,
because
go ahead.
I came from Land Bank. But strictly on the economic or the rational elements associated with it. On the net, I think the merger will be helpful because you get two big banks together. And especially in the case of DBP, the capital adequate ratio of the DBP is not as strong as that of the BSP. They're in need of additional capitalization.
Okay.
This is one way of helping them achieve that. Now, in terms of organization, you know, if you have a big organization, I mean, you're a good CEO, you can actually designate EVPs to handle Agri for Land Bank, DBP taking care of Countryside, the project, and so on. But you know, the one way of handling this type of concerns or dilemma is to ask, is this proposal important and urgent? I usually try to ask this question. There are proposals that are important, but not necessarily urgent. I would consider, even if I have that bias, as I mentioned earlier, I would consider the merger as important, but not urgent. In the same manner, that I thought the Maharlika was important, but not necessarily that urgent. Mm. But it has been decided upon already. So let's help the president and the administration see how we can improve its chances of success or reduce its chances of failure.
Okay.
That's basically what our role now as bystander.
All right.
But trying to help the administration.
We're all playing for the same team after all. Mr. Secretary, one final question. You have worked as well with, so you're watching the son, Marcos Jr., now do his work. But at one point, when you were in public service, you actually worked indirectly for the president's father, Marcos Sr.
Yes, that's right.
Are you seeing striking similarities or differences?
Okay, there are similarities in terms of personality. They're both gentle, they listen, you know. I didn't really have that direct contact with Marcos Sr. I was working through then Executive Secretary Alex Melchor. Mm-hmm. I was with the Presidential Economic Staff as a young professional. Mm-hmm. So Marcos Sr. organized a small team of young professionals to help him monitor the infrastructure program during his time. Mm-hmm. And we were pleasantly surprised that our suggestions or inputs were used by him during his cabinet meeting. So if you hear about slogans like Marcos means more roads, more school buildings, it was largely because he was very, very focused on ensuring that the infrastructure program was going to be implemented. I was hoping that the same focus could be done by Marcos Jr. because I wanted some approximation of what President Ramos used to do with respect to the LEDAC, the Legislative Executive Development Advisory Council. That is a very, very important vehicle in getting things done, not only through the legislative part, but also some executive action. If the members of Congress and the President could come together as often as possible, make quick decisions, monitor the budget, for example, this is very important.
All right. On that note, Secretary, thank you so much for joining us. It was a pleasure speaking with you, sir. This is definitely not going to be the last that we will speak. Thank you for joining us today, sir.